Assalamu alaikum and welcome to episode 2 of our daily Ramadan contest, where you would listen for a few minutes about one of the characters that a Muslim should have, answer a couple of questions, and you'll get a chance to win one of our prizes inshallah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Aktharu ma yudkhulu al-nas al-jannah taqwa Allah wa husn al-khuluq." The two best characters that enter people Jannah, number one is being mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And number two is good morals. Our special thanks for today's sponsors, Mudafa, your one-stop shop for Islamic essentials, shipping conveniently from Dallas, Texas. Halab Pastry USA for your authentic Lebanese pastries and sweets. And Orchid Dates for Medina Ajwa and Majul Dates. If you'd like to sponsor one of these episodes, please call Delilo at 214-205-2908 or send an email to sales@delilo.com. Please click on the link below to submit your answers or visit delilo.com. I will leave you inshallah with our respected guest. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Respected listeners, I pray and hope that every one of you are having a wonderful and spiritually uplifting month of Ramadan so far. As you know that we have been having this program in which we discuss the different qualities that we need to have within our lives as a believer, the qualities of a believer. And today I would like to talk about, or rather give an example of a quality known as wafa. That means that we are true to the word that we say. And men who are true to the word are really part of being true believers. One of the greatest examples that comes to mind is an incident that happens the day before one of the greatest battles in Islamic history, which is the day of Qadisiyah, a war against the Persian Empire. The day before, one of the most, the bravest warriors amongst the Muslim is caught drinking. And this person has had this problem drinking for a while. He has been punished for it multiple times, but unfortunately he is unable to leave it. And due to this, he's brought to the general of the army, and the general army, instead of executing the normal punishment of 40 lashes and allow him to go, he says that let him be locked up. It's very possible because the general of the army on that day himself was suffering illness or injury from a previous fight. And he's locked up in the Battle of Qadisiyah. It starts the next day, and he can hear from his cell that the Muslims are losing, and he thinks, if only I was to be on that battlefield, I could have made a difference. And he prays to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and says, "Ya Allah, if you allow me to be on that battlefield today and grant me this opportunity, I promise never to go back to the barrels again," referring to the wine. And subhanallah, he then calls for the wife of the general and asks her, "Why don't you let me go? I take a promise and I never break my promise. If you let me go, and if I die, then you're free of me. And if I live, then I will come back into the cell and shackle myself up again." The wife thinks for a moment that I may be disobeying my husband and my general if I do so. And she looks out towards the army and she sees the Muslims are losing. And she realizes this man is a valiant warrior. It's very, very possible that he could make a difference in the Muslim army. And subhanAllah, she makes a decision and she brings the key and she opens it for him. And she gives him the horse of the general. And subhanAllah, as he goes out into the battlefield and starts fighting very valiantly, striking left and right, the general is watching from the top. And he says, "If it wasn't for the fact that I know I locked this person up, now I would think that style of fighting refers to is the fighting style of that man that I locked up. And that looks like my horse." After the battle is over and the Muslims come out victorious, then the general inquires about this and he's told by his wife about what had transpired. The general then goes to the cell and he finds that this person is sitting there and he's taking the shackles about to put it back on himself and his eyes are streaming with tears. The general then tells him that from today on, I shall never punish you for drinking again. But the man replies that I shall never go back to drinking again. Subhanallah, what an example. This person had every opportunity to run away, to relieve himself of being in the cell. He could have said, I was the one that was cause of the victory of the Muslims. Why do you punish me? Why do you keep me in prison? But he had given his word that he will come back, and he came back and he was putting the shackles back onto his own hands. Wallahi, this is what it means to be a man of your word. Irrespective of circumstances, irrespective of what level of dishonor it may mean, yet we have to keep our words. Number two, he could have said that, fine, I'll continue drinking since you'll never punish me again. But he had taken an oath with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is what it means to be a believer, that we take an oath with Allah and we keep that word. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all this quality of wafa. Brothers, as you know, and ancestors, that we have a competition. And so I will present my three questions. Number one, what was the name of this man? Number two, what was the name of the general? And number three, what was the name of the horse of the general? I wish everyone the best of luck in answering these questions, and hopefully you continue to have a wonderful month of Ramadan. Last of all, I would like to remind everyone that alhamdulillah, we have taken on 18 different projects trying to help them. So we urge everyone to click on the link below and to donate generously to help all these different projects that are happening with regard to building masajid, renovating masajid, etc., etc., so that it can be a sadaqah jariyah within the month of Ramadan for us. Jazakumullah khairan wa akhiru da'wana and alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Jazakumullah khair for listening. Please click on the link below to submit your answers. And do share with your family and friends, because we will be accepting responses till tomorrow noon, inshallah. And a simple reminder, during this blessed month of Ramadan, we are helping 18 construction and expansion projects for masajids and Islamic schools throughout the United States. So please do donate, and do donate just generously. This is a perpetual charity for 18 projects. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept and reward you for all your ibadah and all your sadaqah. Jazakum Allah khair. We'll see you in tomorrow's episode. Assalamu alaikum.